Hey, what's up everyone? Today I'm working on my dad's Toyota Camry here. He had lost one of his keys, so I ordered him one of these, flipkeys, Toyota flipkey aftermarket ones that I found on eBay and Amazon. I think it was like $22, $23. I'm gonna program it today with my Techstream cable that I've been using for a couple years. It's the MiniVCI cable. I got this for like $20-something on one of these China websites. They're available all over Amazon and eBay right now for about the same price. It works great. The pain in the ass part is trying to get the driver, especially if you're running Windows, anything other than like Windows XP or Windows 7 up and up. You have to get some special drivers for it. So I know I was running it on Windows 8 and now Windows 10. When I upgraded Windows 10, it was fine. But if you're setting it for the first time, you got to go through a lot of steps to get the drivers to work. So I'm gonna, this is my second attempt at it. The first time I ordered these, they actually, I don't know if it was broken or the chip wasn't working or what, but I sent it back and they sent me a new one. So I'll go ahead and show you guys that.
Wireless code registration, that's what it was. Ignition is on. Wait at least 30 seconds after ignition is on for clicking next. Driver's door is open. All other doors closed. Driver's side is unlocked. Registration will fail. Okay, next. On the next screen, you will have to perform the following within 30 seconds. Lock and unlock simultaneously for 1 second. Within 3 seconds, press either lock or unlock for 1 second. That works. Perfect, works. So now we'll program the key to start the car. So we'll go back into, turn the car back on. So now we'll program the key to start the car. We'll close this one. So this is under a different menu now. Under Immobilizer. So you have to find the Immobilizer, which is right here. Next. Go to Utility. Key registration. So we want to go welcome to key registration is used if, so next. All right, everything worked. So what I did was, before I invested in cutting this thing from a locksmith, I just got a $2 key from Lowe's just to make sure that it programmed so it worked.